Now we shall learn what are expression trees and what are predicates. So first of all, we shall start with expression trees. Here we go. Expression trees can be used to store expression in symbolic form. So let us see this very traditional function int sum int a int b return a plus b. If we compile this, this gets compiled into binary. But what are the various parts of this? This one is part is called the parameters part. This part is called the binary expression. It is having two operands, the left, the right. So if we see this from a separate angle, then this entire code has various parts which can be stored separately. One option with us traditionally was to compile it into one single unit. The other option is to break it into various parts and store each part in a symbolic form and then assemble it back on demand. So you understand the concept. This is just breaking this whole function into smaller units and then put them all into a one box having different parts. Then this box is compiled on demand. It is stored as one symbolic unit. When the code is compiled, this symbolic unit is compiled, but not the code in it. The code in it will be compiled at runtime. This code is not compiled, the internal code is not compiled, which is held in symbolic form. But the outer box is compiled. So how is that done? That is done by splitting this whole function into different objects. You store this part in one object of class binary expression. This binary expression is a type of this expression. Generally, this is called the body. This is stored in a property called body. And this whole thing is stored in expression tree. The whole code is put into one box called expression tree. This expression tree has a number of properties. One property is body. The other property, this is one body. The other property is parameters. Then one property is node type. The node type in this case will be the delegate. That can be used to describe this function. The delegate, if you remember, would be something like this: func int comma int comma int. The node type for this expression tree will be func int int int. The node type will be lambda, because it will be stored as a lambda. The node type will be lambda, but the type, this is the third property. Fourth property is type. The type is func int int int. This whole function is stored as one object of call of one object as expression tree. Expression tree is actually denoted by a class called